plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice. Holla, and welcome to this week's plumberparts.co.uk video. Today, we're going to look at indirect vented hot water cylinders. So, enough of me looking cool and amazing, let's have a look at this.
So first up, what we're going to do here is remove an old indirect vented hot water cylinder and put this new one in here. There's a few connections on these that you need to know about and basically how they work. Firstly, we have this part here. This is where our immersion heater goes in. That will screw into there, seal up on this thread and on this flange, and that is basically the electrical backup heater to heat up any water should there be a problem with the coil. If we actually look inside, you will see there is a coil just inside down there that has hot water coming from the boiler that transfers heat into the main hot water cylinder and into the water. That coil is fed by a flow and a return on the side of the tank, just down here. The flow always goes in at the top, hot at the top, and it comes out at the bottom, slightly cooler. So that's your flow and return to the boiler. So you've got a cold feed down here on the opposite side to the heating flow and return. A lot of people will actually tee in their drain off just here, or if it's on the opposite side of the door, you'll run a 15mm pipe round to the front so someone can get to it. Right, so let's have a look at the old tank. We've got very, very tight installation here. This is gonna be a nightmare. Down the bottom here, we've got the drain off. As you can see, the old engineer that fitted this put a little 15mm pipe round so you could get to it, so that's nice and considerate. We've got the thermostat that controls the two port valve or the three port valve, depending on what type of heating system it is. We've got our heating flow and our heating return going into the coil that I showed you on the other tank earlier. And at the top, already removed, we've got the outlet. This is the hot water outlet that goes off to all your taps. And as you can see down the back there, we've got the cold water feed. And as you can see at the top as well, we've got an immersion heater. Generally, when I'm changing these, just put a new immersion heater in, it's worth doing. So at the moment, we're draining down the actual hot water tank itself. We valved off the cold feed just up there, and we are now draining it all down. So once we've done that, we are then going to have to drain down the heating system, so make sure that's all turned off so you can drain that down, and then you'll be able to remove these unions here. So while we're waiting for that tank to drain down, what I usually do is get all the bits and bobs prepared on the new tank to go in. Now, looking at this new inlet here for the immersion heater, what I always find is a good thing to do is, because the immersion heater needs to seal on this flat face that's been covered up by this foam, the first thing I do is get out a knife of some sort and just try and cut the foam back a bit. So I cut round here and remove that foam. Once you've got most of the foam taken off, just get some emery cloth from there, rub that round and give this a good clean. If you want to know how to install an immersion heater into an indirect or a direct cylinder or a vented and unvented cylinder, just go back to our channel, type in change immersion heater, and you'll find our video there. Once you're sure you've drained the actual tank water itself and there's no water coming out of the taps or out of the hose at the bottom, you can cut the pipe that feeds to the tank. Generally, I'd always recommend you cut that pipe high up, especially in a situation like this where the feed tank goes down the back of the cupboard. If you cut it high up, then when you make your second connection, when you put the new tank in, that'll be high up and easy for you to get at. You do not want to be leaning down behind a tank in a cupboard trying to do your connections down there. You want to do that outside or in the room itself. It makes life a lot easier. So once you've cut that pipe, then you can move to the flow and return. Always slacken off the top one first, okay? You only do this when you know you've drained the heating system down and everything. Make sure there's no water coming out there. Slacken the bottom one off. Make sure you've got a towel under there just in case there's a little bit of water or it's still not fully drained. If it isn't, just tighten it up again, go and have a cup of tea, wait. If it is, then you can take it all off. And once you've had your electrician remove the immersion heater, because I all know we use electricians for that, you can carry on taking out the tank itself. But as today's video is more about how indirect hot water systems work and not about how you fit and install and remove them, let's have a quick look schematically at how these systems actually work. So we start off first with our mains cold coming into the building, and that feeds a ball valve in the loft. This tank of water then feeds down to the bottom of our hot water tank. That's what we call the cold feed in. Generally, we'll put in a valve in there so we can isolate the tank if we need to do any work to it. Then out the top, we have the hot water to the system. That goes off to our taps. Now, water, when it's heated up, needs somewhere to expand. So then we take a pipe. This is known as the expansion pipe. And this goes all the way up the system to the top, back to the tank, and just drops in there. So if there's any expansion coming up from this level here, there'll be a small amount that will drip in there, and that shouldn't cause any danger. Now, if it expands a lot and keeps going up, this water level will rise. That's where you have an overflow that will just be here, that will run off down outside the building, so you can see that running. And then, coming from our boiler here, we'll have a flow and return that goes into the coil
and then back to the boiler again. Now, a lot of the time, a heating system has special controls on them, known as a Y-plan or an S-plan system or a C-plan system. There's so many different types. If you want to learn about those systems and how they control the temperature of an indirect hot water tank, just go and have a look. Now, there's another way that these can work, not the tank that I've shown you today, but pressurized and unvented cylinder. If you want to find out about those, go to our unvented cylinders video and go back to our channel. I hope you found today's video on indirect hot water cylinders incredibly informative and that we've helped you out in learning some of the aspects and the principles of how these systems work. If you think we've missed anything out, then do let us know. And as ever, contact us on Facebook, on Twitter, on our channel. Go to our website and say hello there. There's loads of ways for you to get in contact with us. And as ever, subscribe to our videos. I hope you've had a wicked time and I'll see you all later. Hold tight.